Hey everybody, and welcome to Mr. Dixon's Arrested Developments. We're just going to get right into the stories, all right? This first story is from Fox 13 Memphis. Youth pastor, of course, accused of, youth pastor accused of dozens of sex crimes involving minors. Sorry, no booze today. I'm not drinking today. Got medication in me. I'm still fighting these damn colds. This weather is fucked up. Anyway, youth pastor accused, but not as fucked up as the youth pastors. Youth pastor accused of dozens of sex crimes involving minors. This is Tipton, Tennessee. County, Tennessee. A former Tipton County youth pastor has been arrested in connection to sexual abuse of multiple minors. Ronnie Gorton was arrested Tuesday afternoon, according to the Tipton County Sheriff's Office. Gorton was a youth pastor at the Awakening Church. Awakening like his cock. Awakening Church. Sources told Fox 13, this is where Gorton made contact with several of his victims. Well, cheaper than going to a bar. One of Gorton's alleged victims was under 13 years old and under him. Gorton was indicted by a grand jury on 47 counts. That's a lot of counts. Can you count to 47? I can, so can you, but still, it's a lot of counting. They are sexual exploitation of a minor. That's two counts. Contributing to the delinquency of a minor, that's two counts. Furnishing alcohol to minors, that's two counts. Child Protection Act, two counts. Let's say violating Child Protection. I guess Child Protection Act is a crime? That's a weird thing to call it. Child Protection Act. So you can violate it twice, two counts. I assume it's the violation of a Child Protection Act. Surely, a Child Protection Act in and of itself isn't a crime. It's the violation of the child. I'm just assuming here. I know it's Tennessee, but come on. Don't you get married? You can get married at 13 there or something. Aggravated sexual battery, that's five counts. Sexual battery by an authority figure, that's 70 counts. Statutory rape by an authority figure, that's 16 counts. And rape, which I don't have been printed out as a count here. It just says rape. Probably just rape. You don't count that. It just is. All right. Anyway, the 47 indictments represent three victims, so the investigation is ongoing to any other allegations, said Chief Billy Daughtry with the sheriff's office. Police believe there are more victims. Neighbors fear it as well. How did we miss it? Wondered Donnie Overbeck, who lives across the street from Gorton for 2 years. They were all young men that were there, said Janice Godowski. By the way, I can answer how, I can ask you, Donnie, how you overlooked it, because it was a religious figure and you thought, don't want to look and acknowledge him. I'm going to pretend he says Jesus a lot, and so therefore my brain turns off. That's how you overlooked it. Neighbors said a teenage boy actually lived with Gorton's inside their home. So he was his wife's home, and that boys would come over and work out in the garage next door. I'll bet. When they worked out there are usually three or four people are over there working out, said Godimsky. What this indictment alleges is that the victim was repeatedly abused by this individual, said Chief Doherty. One victim, 8 years. Ugh. The investigation began with one victim coming forward to Attock police in January and said he was sexually assaulted multiple times by Gorton. After that report, a friend called police and said Gorton was suicidal, preparing to kill himself. Ah, if only. Police were able to stop Gorton in a car and took him into custody. He should have let him kill himself. All right, anyway. That's that story. Moving on, this is from my LGBTQ Nation, which is a website. A father and son, wow, keep it in the family. My father and son were both on staff for a Baptist church in a suburb east of Dallas, have both been charged for sexual assault of minors who are members of the congregation. That is a long headline. Steve Aaron Wynn, 33, served as an assistant youth pastor at the Open Door Church in Mesquite. Oh, that wasn't the only thing that was open. And worked as a construction inspector in the public works department for the city before he was terminated shortly before his arrest on February 22nd. Who cares what he did in the other stuff? He was an inspector and a pedo. All right. Wynn repeatedly had a sexual relationship with a female student at the church's Christian Academy for more than a year, starting when the girl was 15. His father, this is his father, this is the son of the father, this is sweet stuff, keep it in the family. His father, 65-year-old Larry Allen Wynn, was arrested on March 1st and charged with one count of sexual assault of a child after an interview with the victim, who was now 19 and was 16 at the time. Son's in the 15-year-olds, he was in the 16-year-olds, that's sweet. learned it from good old dad. The police haven't confirmed that the teenage girls are different individuals, so they weren't both banging the same chick, because, you know, they got some principles after all. Larry Wentz was the church's business director, according to NBC5, and ran the bus ministry, providing free rides to children to and from Sunday school and services, according to the Dallas News, and then giving them other free rides. A spokesperson for the church previously stated Steve Wynn was a volunteer, not an employee, but had no other comment. He didn't work here, he just volunteered. Don't blame us. The church made headlines in 2011 when senior pastor Matt Jarrow was arrested on a rape charge in West Virginia. He hanged himself in a cell 2 days later. Well, a little bit of a happy ending there. All right, let's move on. Next story. Former Low Country. A former Low Country youth pastor charged with soliciting minor for sex. This is in Dorchester County, South Carolina, and this is from WCIV. Caleb Lid Jordan, 30, was arrested and charged with 4 counts of exploitation of a minor, including solicitation of a minor for sex. The current Charleston area real estate agent and former youth pastor, and of course, at New Springs Charleston, was arrested in late February after an investigation by local and state law enforcement. A former member of New Springs Church, a former member of New Spring reached out to ABC News 4 to reveal Jordan's role at the church and her concerns. He did his own reaching out. I volunteered at New Springs youth ministry called Fuse, which is every Wednesday night, and Caleb Jordan was the boy's youth pastor at Fuse, that he lit a few times, said the woman, who wished to remain anonymous. He had access as youth pastor to a wide range of young men there. New Spring confirmed Jordan worked at the church in various roles from August 2011 to September 2015, according to the church's communications director, Suzanne Swift. Swift said Jordan passed both federal and state background checks prior to his employment, and there was no cause for concern. Okay. Jordan described his position at his LinkedIn account as the church's Next Steps Direct Campus Pastor Assistant and Student Ministry Director. Swift said Jordan resigned from his role as a campus pastor assistant in 2015, but remained on in a volunteer capacity until his arrest. Everyone's on to, like, volunteer. Once we were made aware of these charges, we immediately terminated his ability to volunteer in any capacity at New Springs, Swift added. She's very swift in her saying that they got rid of him as soon as they found out. New Spring leaders have no reason to believe anything inappropriate had happened between minors and the church in Jordan, and that they have not been contacted by law enforcement, according to Swift. Still, the former member who spoke to us is concerned, given Jordan's former position of trust. Kayla's primary role was to provide care to young men ages 12 to 18 through his role at Fuse at their youth pastor, as their youth pastor, she said. She described care as a type of closed-door Christian counseling. Let me care for you. Behind the door. Let's close this door. And let me care for you. Care for you, you understand? Alright, it's highly alarming to me. We see this happening more frequently, she said, and there's more to it, but I only print out the one page because that's how it works. You can find the story online if you want to read more about it. But all right, so that's Caleb, Lynn, Jordan, whatever. All right, and last but not least, ladies and gentlemen, the last story here. This is Haaretz. This is from Haaretz, an Israeli paper, or global paper. Some of you people have decided to call Jews. You know you're saying Jews when you say globus, right? You're not fooling anybody. Israeli rabbi suspected of leaking nude photos of singer. So model singer, he's got the rabbi was suspected of leaking new videos of them. The naughty, naughty rabbi. Naughty rabbi. Security camera footage of women changing into bathing suits allegedly leaked by settler rabbi who teaches at seminary for girls. Well, first of all, if he's a settler in Israel, he's a douchebag. He's a fucking douchebag. What a piece of shit he already is. This is just shit on top of the shit cake. A rabbi who lives in a settlement in the West Bank, class act, was arrested on suspicion of distributing nude video clips of an Israeli singer and model. He's a pervo and an imperialist. Over the past week, video of the singer Eden Ben Zaken, her middle name is Ben, and model Nita Alkmeister, Altmeister?
Meister!
Trying on bathing suits in Altmeister's swimwear store in Tel Aviv was leaked online. So it wasn't enough for him to see, because I'm going to share this shit with everybody. Look at these girls. The man is suspected of violating the privacy of the two women by distributing the video clips. Yeah, no kidding. But the police are not sure whether he is the person who hacked into the security cameras in the store and downloaded the videos. The punishment for the crime that he is now suspected of is up to 5 years in prison. Well, that sounds good. The 41-year-old man teaches at a seminary for girls. Uh-oh. His detention was extended by court on Wednesday for 5 more days. The man, a father of 6, of course, also works in computers. Neighbors of his said he is a saint. Modest. The last one you would imagine would be involved in such an incident. He's a settler. So that means he definitely ain't no saint. Fuck you. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that is... Oh, this is a very short one today. But so this is Mr. Dixon's Arrested Developments. That's it for now. Thank you very much, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.